Welcome to another video of the RShiny dashboarding series. In this video, we're going to group our data by certain column and then plot that output for making the app. In the previous video, what we did was plot the data as is. What I mean by that is we took a particular column such as sales and then just plotted that and showed the output. So if it is on Excel, it would be looking something like this. I just took all of these values and plotted it. But this time what we are going to do is we're going to pivot the data or summarize the data on certain columns and then plot it. So if I just go to the insert tab and insert a pivot table on this, we'll be able to summarize this data, and on top of that summarized data we'll be plotting a chart. So I'll take, let's say, sales representative to the rows area, and I'm going to take sales to the values area, and we're just going to sum up all the values there. Now when I get that summarized data, if I plot a pivot chart on top of it, this is the chart we'll be looking at. And I can just replace this particular column with, let's say, quarter, and I'll have a quarterly summary of the information that we have here, right? Rarely is a situation where we are just going to plot a chart like this with all of the data. We'll definitely massage the data in a certain way and then look at it. So in the previous video, we did exactly that. We just plotted something like this directly, and now in this particular video we're just going to summarize the data and show the resultant data and plot the resultant data set. So let's see how we can do that. I've taken the same code here, and then I'm going to the other code. In this particular code, I'm going to add library dplyr, which will help us achieve the similar results of what we have with pivot tables. Basically, let's aim to get quarterly data and plot that particular data. So I imported the dplyr library, and now in this particular thing, the process remains the same. I take the sales data and then I plot it, but this time I'm going to plot sales after I've summarized the data. And the UI remains the same. I have a header and I have this plot output. Only thing that is going to change between this step and this step is that summarizing of data. So let's make space for this particular code. I'm going to say summarize data and plot chart. Okay, now here's where we'll summarize the data. I'm going to take DF as my resultant data set. This is how it's going to be. I'm going to take the sales data, which is on top here, and I'm going to now summarize this information by dplyr. So first I'm going to do group by. Okay, so I did the group by, and obviously, while you're doing group by, you want to give the quarter information, right? So much like this particular step, if I just remove all of this, and the first step that we are doing here is doing this, right? So we took the pivot table and we said group by quarter, and we said group by quarter. Okay, so we did that. Now, once that particular thing is done, what we need to do is, this has to be something like this pipe operator, and then this one is also going to be similar. I'm going to take this piece of code here, placed it here. So once I have group by quarter, sales is equal to sum of sales, right? So I get the sales. I'm just going to put this as small s, and I'm going to replace this also with small s. So basically I summarize the information at sales level and I got the sum of sales, much like how we can do it in pivot tables. I'm just going to put sales here, and I'm just going to say value field settings, and I'm going to say, let's say, sum, count, average, or whatever it is, right? So we can give whatever function we want to give. We are giving sum in this particular case. And so now we have this particular summary created. It is going to be looking similar to this. Let's see how it's going to be looking like. And I think this will be capital S, so I'm just going to put that as capital S. Okay, now this is fine. Now I should run this, and instead of having a sales plot like this, now we will be getting a plot such as this. So let's look at how we can get that plot. So if I run this app, say save selected, and look at the data, I'll be getting this particular plot. Obviously, we can replace our axis names and all of that here, but we'll keep that for a later video. In the next video, we'll see how we can use ggplot because there is little room for improvement in this default plotting system of R. So we will explore ggplot2 and see how we can make the charts more beautiful and add other things along with it also.